Welcome back to Northwestern Outdoors Radio. I'm John Kruse. We continue broadcasting from Shoto, Montana, and we've got a really special guest for you. His name is Dave Trexler. He is a real-life paleontologist. That's right, a dinosaur fossil hunter. He is also the curator for the Two Medicine Dinosaur Center, and he even took us out to find dinosaur fossils today. Dave, thanks for a fantastic and exciting day in the field.
Well, thanks for coming out with me.
Well, this was truly a once-in-a-lifetime experience, and I want to share with folks later during our conversation how they can have this sort of experience too. But before we get there, I want to talk about you. I mean, I've never met a real paleontologist who does field work looking for dinosaur fossils, looking for dinosaur eggs. How did you get into this business? You're just a small-town kid from Shoto.
My mother was the one who first sparked my interest. She found her first dinosaur bone when she was 5 years old back in 1917, and my family has actually been interested and observant on fossils from an amateur standpoint ever since.
You were telling me earlier that as a young kid in your teens, you would go out with your mother and you would find dinosaur fossils, and you knew at a very early age this is what you wanted to do for a living.
It is. Well, not necessarily for a living. I also knew that there isn't a really good future for monetary support in this field, but it is something that I always wanted to do as a love in life, if you will. And what really sparked my interest was the discovery of my first significant fossil. And that happened when I was 15 years old, and I've really been hooked on a professional basis ever since.
And what was that fossil? What kind of dinosaur was it?
It was a articulated part of a skeleton from a duckbill dinosaur. Means it was in life position, so all the bones were in order. And what happened then was we traveled the state to compare what we had found to what was theoretically on display in other parts, because I had read so much about what had been found here in Montana, and you know, many, many dinosaurs. Should have been a lot of material, but there wasn't. There was one dinosaur in display in the entire state. And that kind of made me sad and mad. And we decided that we needed to fix that. So that's what I've been doing ever since.
Not only that, I mean, you basically, it was that caused you and your mother to basically develop the Two Medicine Dinosaur Center. Why don't you tell our listeners how this came about?
Well, the Two Medicine Dinosaur Center actually was a spawn from the local museum here in Shoto, and I had gone to graduate school for paleontology specifically to do the kind of research we needed done here at the museum. And like any small nonprofit, we're subject to the will of the board. And when I got back, the board had decided that they wanted to be an educational museum and not a full research facility. And I hadn't gone to 9 years of college to tell people about what other people were researching and not be able to do my own. So we branched off and formed a research center, which is now the Two Medicine Dinosaur Center.
And there is a research center there, but there also is an educational component. And what are people going to find when they walk through the doors? I know I sure enjoyed it.
The museum is open from 1st of May through end of September every day. The winter, we are open only by appointment. But we do have a couple of things that are really important in the facility. We have on display the very first baby dinosaur bones found in a nest anywhere in the world. They were the actual baby dinosaurs that spawned the renewed interest in dinosaurs back in the early 1980s and late 1970s.
And your mother found this, didn't she?
Yeah, that was my mother's discovery, the first baby dinosaurs in North America.
That is so cool. So you've got the baby dinosaur there. What else?
We have, according to the Guinness Book of World Records, the world's largest scientifically accurate dinosaur on display. It is a model of an animal called Seismosaurus, and it is 137 feet long, 23 feet tall at the hips.
And we've got to talk about T-Rex.
T-Rex?
Well, not your license plate on your car, which is T-Rex, but you've got some skulls in there from T-Rex.
We have actually several skulls from Tyrannosaurids, the family that includes T-Rex. And we do have a T-Rex skull. But the more important skulls that we have are actually discoveries of new species of Tyrannosaurs that inhabited this part of the country several million years before T-Rex roamed this part of the country.
And the amazing thing is, number one, with the exception of the replica dinosaur that's the longest one, the largest one, all these other exhibits, they're from right here in this local area.
That's right. We've put on display what we have found. The museum part of what we're doing is actually kind of a museum in reverse. We're a research and education facility. We take people out to help us do our research. And the result is, of course, we recover some really cool stuff.
And I want to talk about that because we had an awesome time with you today. Folks, if you go out with Dave on one of these trips, I guarantee you, you will find dinosaur fossils. And to me, that was the coolest thing. And I love the fact how you started out by training our eyes to recognize what a fossil was. First off, let's talk about the tours. When are they offered? How much do they cost?
Our programs are offered on a first-come, first-served basis, so they're available whenever we have staff and the weather's cooperating, and it's by advance registration. You call us when you have a week that you might be out with us, and we see how that matches with our calendar, and if it matches, you can come out.
So $75 a head. And folks, don't be scared of that price. I mean, again, this is truly a once-in-a-lifetime experience. You're going to spend about half a day. You're going to go out to a bed where fossilized dinosaur fragments and bones are found from duck-billed dinosaurs. So all the science has been done in this area. There's no need to do any more science. And so people can actually go and they can actually look for them and pick them up. And you've got a great test for us rookie paleontologists that helps us figure out whether we're holding onto a rock or whether we're holding on to a fossil. And it's the stick test. Why don't you tell our listeners what that's all about?
Fossils are permineralized, and tubes that small have the habit of sucking moisture off of any surface that you might put up against it if there's moisture present. And your tongue is very moist, so if you put your tongue against a dinosaur bone, it probably will stick to your tongue after a few seconds.
Now, the area we're working in, though, has a lot of cow pies, and so you were really good about us saying, look, I don't want you sticking a cow pie on your tongue, so instead, put your tongue on your finger, get your finger wet, pick it up, and hold it for 10 seconds. And if it sticks, there's a 70% chance that that's going to be a fossil. And you know what? It worked for me 100% of the time. It was fantastic.
Yeah, it's a fairly robust test. It works as long as the microscopic tubules are not infilled. It works pretty well.
Well, and not only that, when you're done with your tour, this is what I love. If I'm ever out and about, I will actually recognize a fossil. I mean, you have literally trained my eyes to recognize what a fossil looks like. And once you take the time to do that, this is knowledge I'll have the rest of my life. And folks, where else can you go and look at fossils and pick one up and literally hold something that is anywhere from 75 million to 320 million years old? I can't think of anywhere else where you're going to have this opportunity. Again, it's the Two Medicine Dinosaur Center. Is there a website we should steer people towards?
TMDinosaur.org.
That's TMDinosaur.org. TMDinosaur.org. Just a short drive from Shoto, Montana. Come on out here to Central Montana and check out the Two Medicine Dinosaur Center. Sign up for one of these fossil expeditions and literally walk where the dinosaurs walked and pick up the fossilized bones. Thank you so much for a great day today, Dave. It was truly an educational experience and something I'll never forget, and I hope our listeners get to enjoy this too.
Well, thank you for coming out with us.
In the heart of the North Cascades Mountains of Washington State, at the head of Lake Chelan, lies a small community called Stehekin. Stehekin is a special place and not accessed by road. Part of the adventure is getting here by boat, helicopter, airplane, or by trail. Stehekin Valley Ranch, with delicious food, comfortable cabins, and a magnificent setting, is your place to stay while enjoying hiking, fishing, horseback riding, kayaking, bicycling, or just plain relaxing. StehekinValleyRanch.com, where your next adventure awaits.